Hey everybody, it's Bible Girl, and today we're going to have an episode of R&R. For those of you who are new to R&R, R&R stands for Recap and Review. I go over books that I have read before and talk about them in more detail. Today, we are going through Breaking Dawn, and for my non-Twilight fans, sorry, we'll be doing this until the movie comes out. In fact, I'm going to actually make less episodes of an R&R than I normally would so we can get through it. I'm going to do about 2 chapters an episode. And we are only going to talk through book 3. Breaking Dawn is split up into 3 books. And unlike book 2, which the chapter started a new number, they don't for book 3, which is odd. But today we're doing book 3, Bella, preface, through chapter 20, which would be the first 2 chapters. The beginning is a flash forward where Bella is seeing the Volturi coming and she's protecting her child. And initially she's scared, and then it changes and she's ready to take them on. Then we go into the main story, and Bella is in a lot of pain. Unlike the film version of Breaking Dawn, part 1, it is book 3 starts with Bella still in labor. So Bella's in labor, she is slipping into death. She can feel it coming at her, but she's fighting. And this is something I love about Bella in Breaking Dawn. And so many people say otherwise, but I see a fighter, and I see someone that's going to do nothing but protect her children, her child, and the people she loves. So I think that's cool about Bella in this book. And eventually, the child is born. She assumes it's a boy and then finds out it's her daughter, Renesmee. She gets to see Renesmee for like a second, and then she's fading very quickly. And this is all from Bella's perspective, which is interesting, but she does get the venom put into her, and instead of just feeling like the crushing blackness of death coming upon her, she is in the most intense pain she has ever experienced, burning like she's on fire. That's how she feels, because she has the venom in her and is becoming a vampire. Downside, in order to try to make this easier, they gave her a ton of morphine. So instead of it making it easier, Bella is not only in extreme pain, but cannot move. So we see Bella go through this whole transformation through her perspective, wishing she could die, forgetting why she even should have been born. And then she gets to a point where she remembers why she's fighting for this, for the people she loves, and for her daughter. And she has this moment of clarity of love for her daughter, which I think is awesome and beautiful. Eventually, she does start getting close to waking up. Edward is concerned because she's not moving, which is really weird for someone that's becoming a vampire. But Carlisle reassures him, and sure enough, Bella comes too. And the family all comes up except for Renesmee and Rosalie, who are downstairs. And people are a little afraid because newborns are very strong. In fact, Jasper's very protective of Alice and just very protective in general. And he's very confused because once Bella gets over how distracting everything is, like, you can see the reflections and everything is so much clearer and you can taste things in the air, and just being a vampire is a very intense thing. Bella's kind of fine. She's thirsty, but she's fine. She wants to see Renesmee, but everyone's very, very much opposed to it. And Edward tells her, let's go hunting. But before they go hunting, Alice grabs a mirror, forces Bella to look at it. And at first, she's so confused. She doesn't recognize this beautiful, beautiful woman in front of her. And then slowly looking, she sees things like the shape of the lip and things like that that remind her of herself. So now Bella's about to go hunting. She's in a really pretty dress because, well, Alice is Alice and she dressed her. So these are the first 2 chapters of Breaking Dawn book 3. your daughter. It's very much in Bella's head, a lot of it, and dealing with the pain and then the almost euphoria of experiencing the differences between human and vampire. I was just reading them, even if you're not going to read the rest of the book, just because they are really cool from her perspective, seeing what it's like. Okay, guys, I love you all. God bless. And I'm pretty sure you'll see me tomorrow because we've got to go through this quickly. Bye. Oh, wait, before I go, if you're still watching, I am currently in a costume contest on MuggleNet.com. I'll put the info down the doobly-doo. I am a finalist in the Harry Potter costume contest. This is a really big deal because MuggleNet is like tied as one of the top two Harry Potter sites in the world. And I could win cool stuff. So if you could go and vote for me, I'm listed as Hufflepuff Student by Ashley B. I'd love you so much because it would be really cool to win. Okay, goodbye for real.